Jason Wee Man Acuna, Preston Lacy. And your name is what?
That's Trisha.
Trisha.
That's my better half.
Thanks for coming, Trisha.
She's actually, right now, everybody from the Jackass crew found out she's carrying my baby.
Oh, wow. Jeez. Congratulations.
Yeah. You slipped one past the old goalie.
Yeah.
Wow. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, very cool. Very cool. And congratulations on the movie opening this weekend.
Yes.
Yeah. Unbelievable. You know what? I'm just going to start taking calls right away.
They're just ringing in, huh?
I'll talk more about my broken leg and whine about it because I know these people want to talk to you.
All right.
It's 8:10 Pacific Daylight Time here in Los Angeles. 11:10 Eastern, and we're live on the internet on Webovision. Hello, you're on the air with Wee Man and Preston.
Hey, Tom, how's it going?
Good, how are you doing?
Good, how's your leg?
It sucks.
I can imagine.
Yeah.
Surgery.
Yeah.
Hey, I was wondering, for Wee Man, if you're going to do another Jackass?
We don't know yet right now. We're just excited. Our second movie's in the theater right now. We're all praying.
It's sold out.
Yeah, it's sold out everywhere.
was the idea to do a second one something that happened right away after the first one, or did you guys take a while to decide to do that?
No, we took a while to decide. We weren't even thinking of making a second one. Preston and I were already just finishing up filming another movie with like four other Jackass members.
Right. Who else? How many Jackass members are there?
There's nine of us.
Nine, okay.
Yeah, there's Knox, me, Preston, Bam, Steve-O, Chris, Ryan,
Aaron.
Dave, and Aaron.
Yeah. Right.
And then there's some fringe guys, too. Like, Bam's got his crew in Philadelphia, Rake, and his brother Jess, and Deco, Brandon DiCamillo. And then, of course, there's Cossack and Dimitri, our guys here, too. Because our crew gets it just as bad as we get it on our show.
Right. How do you guys... When did you guys all meet, then? Was it, like, people from around the country all came together, or how's that...
Yeah, like, a lot of people know that over here on the West Coast, we were doing the Big Brother magazine and Big Brother videos.
Yeah.
And then Bam and those guys were doing the CKYs.
Did you guys know each other then?
Yeah, we knew of each other. Like, I didn't know Bam, and Preston didn't know Bam. till we all realized that both those videos were selling to the mainstream audience outside of the skateboard industry for all the shenanigans we caused.
Cool. Did you guys know each other in L.A. before?
No, not at all. We met in the Jackass office on the first day we filmed.
Awesome.
Yeah.
When I chased him down the street in our underwear.
Hello, you're on the air. It's just, I know.
Hello?
Everyone always gets mad at me because I just want to talk to you guys. And
that's all right.
And everyone gets mad at me in the blogs because I don't take enough calls. And we have a lot of people watching today. We probably have like well over 175 people watching today.
No way.
So, hello, you're on the air.
How you doing, sir?
Good, good, good.
How you doing, Preston and Wee Man?
Hey, we're doing good.
I have a question for you two, Preston and Wee Man.
Awesome.
I wanted to know what's your guys' favorite stunt to do on or off camera.
Good.
Well, in the last movie, our favorite stunt together was the bungee jump from the aqueduct in Florida. But I think my favorite Wee Man bit in the last movie.
Wait, you guys did a bungee jump together?
Yeah.
Well, it was a human bungee. They tethered us together with a bungee cord and put us up together on top of a Rickenbacker Causeway in Florida. And we jumped off, came down, he started coming back up. And as he was coming back up, the momentum jerked me off. And we went down and we did the flying 69.
The momentum jerked you off?
Yeah. The momentum jerked me off.
Yeah. My 130 pounds momentum jerked off this guy.
Yeah, jerked me off the bridge. So then he came up and he came within a foot of hitting his head on the bottom of the bridge, but I jerked him down into the water.
Now, wait, what are your worst injuries? Thank you for your call. What are your worst injuries? Because this is just almost sort of just a bizarre... I don't normally get injured.
Yeah.
I've been injured a lot in the last 6 months. I broke two ribs a few months ago, and then just a few days ago I had the surgery in my leg. It's funny, and then somebody emailed me a very similar x-ray of your... What happened to your leg? Was that something for Jackass?
No. It was before... We already knew we were going to start filming Jackass.
Yeah.
And me and some friends had a couple beers and went and skated at a friend's ramp. And like right warming up, third try, I fell off the top of the ramp and broke my right femur in a spiral break.
Yeah.
So it looked like a candy cane.
I'm just sort of feeling it.
Yeah. So then I did it October 3rd, October 4th. I have an 11-inch titanium rod and three titanium screws in it holding it together.
So that goes off in metal detectors, right?
Yeah, all the time. Like the other day I went into the airport and I like took everything out and it beeped and I'm like, oh yeah, I have a metal rod in me. Yeah, and
I have this little thing in me now, in my ankle.
That's all right.
That'll go off in a metal detector, do you think, though?
Yeah. Yeah. Anything will.
Cool. Hello?
Tom.
Cool, man. I go off in a metal detector now, too. Hello, you're on the air. Give us a call, 323-845-9976. That's my home number. Yeah, I'm feeling good.
That's good to hear. Hey, Wee Man. Hey, Preston. How'd the shooting for the movie go? Do y'all really like doing it? Or are you going to do it again?
We had that question already. You have to ask another question.
Damn,
we already said, it's too early to decide.
Why don't we have a combination?
Let them rest a minute.
Jackass movie.
Let them rest for a minute, they have to. There's probably a lot of injuries and stuff on the movie, right?
Let's have a combination Jackass Tom Green movie next year.
That's what this is right now.
We're
meeting online.
Baby steps.
Oh, okay.
Baby steps.
Yeah.
There's a lot of like. People don't really think about what they're going to ask when they're online.
No, you don't understand. You don't understand, though. You really. You don't understand. We've been doing this for 8 weeks, and this is really good tonight. Normally, they would call up and say, barrel roll.
That's it?
That's it. And then hang up. Giggle and hang up.
Tom Green, what's going on? And then hang up.
Like, cocksucker. You know, and hang up. That's all it's been for 2 months. Cocksucker. You know? So this is awesome. There's sentences involved here. No, thank you guys. You're doing a good job. Good job compared to, you know, previous episodes. Keep up the questions.
Yeah.
Try to ask different ones every time though.
We have
Hello?
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, I have a question.
Yeah.
I'm on a Steve-O chat right now and everybody wants to know what the scariest stunt they've ever done was.
The scariest what?
Stunt.
Scariest stunt.
How about for you, P?
Oh, just probably that bungee thing we're talking about, just because I'm scared of heights. I have a really big fear of heights.
He was shaking like this at the top of the bridge. It was a 40, 50-foot bridge, and Preston's like this, drinking water, just shivering. And I had to, like, take over and be like, Preston, we're doing this. And if it wasn't for me jumping, we would have walked away with no footage.
Yeah, they're like, okay, you guys do the introduction on this bit. And I'm like, I ain't saying nothing, Jason. Just do it. Just say it. I ain't saying nothing.
Man, so there's like, there's pressure sometimes to jump off the bridge, right?
Oh, absolutely. It's like the greatest job in the world when you're not actually filming. But when you're actually the one under the gun, it's hell.
Yeah, yeah.
But besides that time,
everyone's looking at you.
It's the funnest job ever to just sit and laugh at people doing stupid stuff.
Uh-huh.
It's a blast.
Cool. Thanks for your call.
Thank you.
Okay, bye. Hello? Hello? You're on the air.
What's going on, Tom?
So far, I would say that the calls have been better than average, right?
Oh, really?
Have you watched this show before?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's Hunter. What's going on?
Yeah, the calls are pretty good, right? I'd say even you right now are better than average as far as callers go. Would you agree?
Oh, I would agree, man. Yeah. I'll definitely agree.
Yeah, you're doing great right now.
All right. Well, so how's everything going? How are you healing up?
I mean, move it along, though, a little. Make it a little more interesting.
Oh, definitely. Yeah. All right. You want to hear my question I have for Wee Man?
Yeah, exactly.
All right. First of all, the Jackass movie was great. It was awesome.
Did you see the new one this weekend?
Yeah, I didn't actually want it to be over with, even. Like, it was so good.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, what a nice thing to say, buddy. Thank you.
Yeah, dude. There was a bad people in the movie theater, too. There was a lot of people there, so I'm sure you guys are doing good on that part. But my question was, I was wondering if you had any, like, uncut, or how much uncut footage, or, like, that you had that... Gonna make it to the DVD.
What is the shooting ratio?
Shooting ratio.
Yeah, like you shoot like hundreds of hours of footage and whittle it down to 1 hour.
Shot a 3-hour movie of A+ footage, but we know that our crowd can't sit in a movie theater for 3 hours.
Well, you know, he said he wanted it to be longer.
Yeah, I
guess the fringe could, but most people, your average person,
lots of DVD extras.
Oh, yeah? Well, we're sitting on 40 minutes of gold footage right now that we haven't given up to anything. No credits or nothing yet.
It's somewhat exciting, the world we find ourselves in, where this stuff can just be put on a DVD and sold. And, you know, it's interesting. You know, it's a. I mean, I know, like, it's a. You know, people out there. Yeah, it just must feel good to be able to have this all in one spot. People out there can get this stuff.
God bless mommy and daddy and Walmart.
You feel good about technology? You feel good about the future of technology?
Hello, Tom.
You feel good about the future, sir?
I feel good about the future.
Yeah.
You kidding me?
Yeah. Are you feeling good about it?
I'm the guy who sent in the X-ray, man. You know how I define.
You sent in the X-ray of right. That's what I'm saying. Here we are. We're on the internet. It's the future is basically here right now. Well, no, now we're basically in the future. From where
he sent you the future of the past.
He sent me your leg earlier. Now we're here talking about
it. That's how I got
it. It's just
though.
A wired world, man. It's crazy.
I have a good question here, Tom.
Okay, good. Thank you.
First of all, a shout out to you. To you, we man. And also, my question is basically, you know, you guys have kind of like an Abbott and Costello feel. I mean, you know, and would you guys ever think about like having your own show, like where it's just you guys? You know?
Wee Man and Preston?
Yeah, Abbott and Costello, maybe, you know, something like that. I mean, I could totally see that happening.
Doing sort of a comedy duo. Thanks for your call.
Totally, totally. I'm so glad. I heard only Wee Man was coming. I'm Preston. I'm glad you showed up.
Oh, yeah. Awesome. Thanks.
Yeah, buddy.
And you guys are a team, and I just think that you guys...
Okay, we got the point. Are you guys a comedy team?
We're more like Dom DeLuise and Burt Reynolds, yeah. though, than Abbott and Costello.
Yeah.
You guys ever do like live stuff together? Or?
We have. We used to do the Steve-O tour.
Right, I'm sure.
All the time. And Steve-O would come out and be like, yeah, Dave, blah, 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 me. And the next thing you know, it would be us coming out on stage. And people would cheer. They loved us.
Yeah. No, except when Steve-O had the audience irate at him. It was a really fun show. So really
yeah, where's Steve-O right now?
He's probably in Hollywood. Well, he's probably in his house. He has two apartments in the same apartment building.
When is Steve-O coming over here? Call him right now and ask him to come over here. Could you send him a message for me?
Yeah.
Because I've tried to send this message to him. I think my mother went to high school with his mother.
Oh, absolutely she did.
Really?
Yes.
And I've never talked to him about it.
Yeah, he's got Canadian residency, too.
In Barrie, Ontario,
yeah,
Canada.
Yeah, absolutely.
My mother... found this out recently, was good friends with his
Steve-O's
mother. I mean, what are the odds on that?
Yeah, no, we'll talk, I'll get you all his
That's
information.
Bizarre.
We'll
so
get him, up here as soon as
we
can.
My mother wants me to sort of talk to him about that, because she was really good friends with his mother.
That's rad.
Yeah.
Steve-O's cool. His dad's cool, too.
Yeah, I've met him before. He came on the show that you did on MTV.
Yeah.
But I haven't seen him since, I'd love him to come to...
Now, we'll get him up here. Bigger than shit.
Yeah. Call him right now. Tell him to get over here. Hello, you're on the air.
Hey, Wee Man and Preston, how are you guys doing?
We're doing awesome.
Cool. I've got a couple questions for you guys. For Wee Man, what are some of your favorite skateboard tricks? And for Preston, I'd want to know what you did on Jay Leno in 1992.
I'll just walk on Jason. On the credits, they just put what year Jay Leno started on there. I was on there in 1999. I did the sketch comedy in the beginning of the show, just goofy sketch acting like... they had an airline for fat people, and I was one of the fat guys, and they had a fat guy say the darndest things, and I was one of the fat guys, and it just basically get the theme there. Yeah, so I didn't do anything in 1992. I was in high school.
Those websites lie.
They sure do.
That's cool. But you did work on Jay Leno.
Yeah, I was only for 2 years.
You grew up here in Los Angeles?
No. I moved out. As soon as I got out of school, I moved out here from southern Missouri, from the Ozarks.
Oh, okay.
By Branson.
Awesome.
Branson, Missouri.
I love Missouri. And I hitchhiked through there once, back in the 60s. Hello? Hello?
Hey.
Hey. Man, I tell you,
right
before the show, I was feeling a lot of leg pain, and we discussed...
You ain't
we
feeling
discussed,
shit,
We discussed
now.
Whether or not we thought it was a good idea for me to maybe take one of my pain pills that I was prescribed by my doctor for my broken leg that I actually have right now.
Yep.
I wasn't sure if it was a good idea. You suggested that maybe I should. You're a man who's been injured before. I took your advice, and boy, you were right.
You feel good right now, don't you?
I'd say this may be one of the best nights of my life, and I'm happy to be spending it with you, sir.
High five.
No, this is good. I should be in a lot of pain right now.
But
hello,
you're
on the air.
I like Vicodin, too. I got a question for you.
I can see why it caught on so much with so many people. Hello.
Hey, Adam from Texas. I had a question for Jackass. I wanted to know if you guys were thinking of making a documentary about, like, the history of Jackass. It's been quite a few years. I'm
I'm really excited on seeing something like that.
Well, I'm sure there will be, but it won't be us making it. It'll be Lance Bangs. He's a videographer, Spike Jones' personal videographer.
So he behind the scenes of the behind the scenes.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
And then behind the scenes of
cameras filming cameras.
Yeah.
That's cool.
We got it.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
You're on the air.
All right. I had a question for Wee Man and Preston to see if they were going to tour with Steve-O again.
He's talking to us right now about it. He's trying to get his tour going, but we've gotten so many offers for other things that we've told Steve-O that keep us in mind, and if we have open time during his dates, we'll show up on him.
Fuck yeah, rad, man.
Cool, buddy.
Where are you?
I am actually on the Steve-O message board right now.
Where are you calling from? Not in the cyber world. In the actual world that we are living and breathing in.
In his parents' house.
Where? What part of the country?
In my bedroom.
Where are you?
Wisconsin.
Wisconsin. Tells me it's Earl. Cool, man. Thanks.
I'm on the Steve-O chat. Where?
Yeah, yeah.
In my bedroom. Where?
That's what "where are you" means to these people. Hello.
Hello.
You're on the air.
What's up, Tom?
How you doing?
Pretty good. I'm a big fan of you, man. But I wanted to ask Wee Man and Preston. First of all, Preston, what you did with Phil and Ape? That shit was funny, man. It was really funny.
Oh, thank you. No, that was really one of the scarier things I've done.
He wanted to
it was
ask
hilarious,
you, and then
man.
He still tells
but,
you it's
look,
funny.
Man, what you and Wee Man, man, what made y'all think to start recording this and start putting it out in the air, man, for people to watch? I mean, what influenced y'all to do that? I mean, I know it's just a bunch of friends recording goofy shit, but what made y'all put it out there?
We were shooting skateboard videos. And we realized people outside of the skateboard videos were buying our videos to watch us hurt ourselves and be dumb. And it's like a college version of America's Funniest Home Videos. You know, you're going to turn it on and watch people.
I remember watching the old skate video. Like, how old are you? Are we the same age?
I'm 33.
Yeah, okay. I just turned 35. And I remember watching the old Future Primitive and Animal Chain videos and just thinking, wouldn't it be awesome just to be able to have a video camera, you know, back those days? So, yeah. Now, where did I hang up on that last guy?
Yeah.
I wanted to ask him another question. I always
we
do
got
that.
Rid of him.
I hung up on that guy.
He was a real wordsmith.
Jeez, yeah. 323-845-9976. That's the number. We're live. We're the only live show on the internet, really, like that's doing this regularly. Phone.
That's rad. I feel glad to be that I'm on
this. This is new technology, bleeding edge technology, courtesy of maniatv.com. And you're watching us there and on tomgreen.com. We're here with Wee Man and Preston Lacy. It's 8:28, and you're on the air.
Am I on Webovision?
Yeah, you're on Webovision. We have 30 minutes left here. So, make it good.
I saw the movie this weekend. I loved it. And personally, I could have sat through 3 hours of it. And let's face it, the weed wears off after an hour anyway, right?
Mm-hmm. The weed wears off after an hour.
Hello, you're on the air.
Hi, I got a question for Preston.
Yep.
Go ahead.
And Jackass 2 and the fart mask skit. Did you mean to poop in the little cone, or was that like a?
Well, no, I didn't. I did not mean to. I didn't poop for a couple of days because I wanted the farts to be real good, and I was on like a chili and tamale diet.
America wants to know. And then you mean to poop in the little cone?
And then when I did, I thought it would be like more of an explosive, like, but instead it was just like a Hollywood turd. It was tapered on both ends, consistent length, consistent color. It's beautiful.
We are clarifying these questions for you, ladies and gentlemen. Hello!
Hello!
Yes!
Hey, Tom, what's up?
Well, we're having fun here. We're having fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wanted to congratulate the guys on the Jackass movie. I saw it this Friday, and I thought it was great. I wanted to ask Wee Man about that scene where he runs around naked off the little... He comes in there, and he's walking in naked on that big table. How does he feel about it? Was it fun shooting that scene?
Yeah, actually, we were done shooting for the day, and then me and Jeff, the director, were in the jacuzzi. And we looked over to this convention hall of our hotel, and we saw a Chipotle meeting going on.
Yeah, Jeff, it was hilarious. I didn't know what it was, and people just saw you walk across. I mean, it was kind of weird seeing you naked and all, but it was just hilarious.
Hey, you know, a dude's got to strut his stuff.
No, I know. I'm used to seeing it from your guys. Well, I don't know. You guys weren't in CKY, but I was used to seeing it from, like, the CKY stuff, too, because they always did that. Bam and all them did all that stuff, too.
So. Yeah.
It's awesome. Nice to hear an actual conversation on this show happening, you know, where people are actually conversing. This guy's actually very enthused and interested in hearing the answer that, to the question that he's asking. Because often it's just people calling up and saying a bunch of nonsense. So
we're good to have some good calls here tonight.
That's what we're trying to do. We got, you know, I smashed this phone system in a fit of rage a few weeks ago because it wasn't working. This is actually it. Do we have to send this to someone? Didn't we sell this on eBay? This was the old...
$500.
For $500.
$500.
Yeah, it's not even worth that much if it's working. But we smashed it because it never worked. People were hacking into it. This has been the most solid... We've been on for about 6 weeks now. This is the most solid the phone system has been.
That's a pretty sweet phone, man.
People are calling and have real questions. You know, I appreciate you guys coming on after your, you know, after, you know, you just had a great opening weekend. You know what? It's nice of you to come by here.
No, thanks for having us.
We love you. My goofy little television channel here. Hello, you're on the air.
Yes, hi.
Yes.
I was wondering, how long did it take to shoot the entire Jackass movie?
7 months.
7 months?
Yep.
Very sweet. Then, did you guys plan to make a third movie? I don't know if it was as before. I'm sorry about that. If it was,
a what? No, oh, a third movie?
We're not gonna respond to that.
Nah.
Hello.
I just had a question for Weeman and Preston.
Yes.
I heard there was talk after the first video that they wouldn't be making a second one, and just wanted to know what the deciding factor was to make the second one.
That would be our leader, Johnny Knoxville.
Yeah.
It's like Jay-Z retiring too, you know. I mean, he retires, and then it's a good thing to do. I think Bette Midler did it. I think at one point, and what's her name, the singer there who was in Yentl, Streisand.
Streisand, yeah.
She I wouldn't know that. And then when you come back, it's that much more exciting. Well, Jay-Z's coming back. I just saw it on the CNN scroll this morning. Hello.
Hello.
Hey.
Hey, Tom, how's it going?
Everybody's saying, when are you doing the next one? Like, you got to go out right away and do
it. Like, let us get this one into the theater and let it last a little.
They couldn't have seen it more than 3 days ago. Yeah. That's the longest period they could have seen it. I don't get it.
Is it like you're going to be, like dragged out to some canyon somewhere and sitting in a rocket or something?
It's like on Porky's, that big void between Porky's 2 and Porky's 3.
Are you going to start? Will you start shooting right away, though? Do you have to start shooting right away now at this point? You kind of have to, right? You got to make another one now, right?
We can't confirm nor deny those.
Hello, you're on the air.
Hi, Tom.
Hey.
With no pain?
I'm feeling good.
Wanted to ask Wee Man a question.
Yeah.
What was the most outlandish thing that Steve-O or Johnny Knoxville did that didn't appear on video or in the mainstream?
Well, Steve-O, he got slightly injured in this film, so he didn't film that much.
What happened?
It's in the credits. John Waters threw Steve-O downstairs in a luggage cart.
John Waters, the director?
The director.
Okay.
Creepy director.
Right, yeah, sure.
Threw him down these stairs in a luggage cart, and he pulled a muscle in his back, right in his back spine.
Yeah.
And so he kind of just laid out and didn't film that much, so... All the footage you see of Steve-O, that's what he did. And Knoxville, same exact thing. Well, he didn't get hurt or anything, but everything he shot, he wanted everybody to see. So there's nothing we're holding back of those guys.
Yeah. Not to sound too serious or anything, but can I ask a serious question?
Sure.
How do you feel about the Steve Irwin thing? I mean, you guys must have pretty...
Oh, man. That guy's on a whole nother level. That guy's a super professional guy, you know what
right.
I mean?
But, I mean, it's being out doing all this dangerous video and then to... have you guys ever worried that there'd be a serious accident with you guys?
All the time.
Well, there's always a concern, but we just hate comparing ourselves to Steve Irwin. Yeah, he's such a great man.
He's on a whole nother level.
Teacher with us dipshits.
Yeah. I'm not comparing it in the sense of the message,
being out there kind of doing the same thing.
Yeah, wrestling alligators and doing this dangerous stunty stuff on video for a television thing that is demanding.
It's like sports, though, same thing. It's such a risk, playing football is the same thing.
Or going out and standing in front of a 90-mile-hour fastball, you know?
Yeah,
you
but know? I mean, when you're getting shoved downstairs in a luggage cart, you're kind of taking that risk, yeah, I guess.
You are.
Yeah.
Especially when you're wearing nothing but a G-string and a bellman's cap.
Hello, you're on the air. Hello?
Oh, see ya.
Hello? Hello, you're on the air.
Hi, I have a question for Wee Man. I just need to know, when he did the trick for John Waters' magic trick, what was the first thing going through his mind when the lady jumped on him?
The first thing going through my mind was, hopefully I make it out of this alive, and that we don't break Jeff Tremaine's extra bedroom bed, because it was in there, and once she landed, I heard it just go, wah! We bent it, too.
Okay.
So, it was bad.
Hello? Hello? Your question?
Hey, this is Deputy Corey Mixter. What's going on, man?
Hey, Corey, how are you?
So good.
Young videographer from, where are you from again? Saginaw, Michigan?
Got it, man.
That's right.
Damn,
that's the entertainment capital of the world.
I've had yet, man. I'm pumped about it.
Well, you know, I first of all, I'm hopped up on meds. We've got some funny people here. And, you know, we've had a good week. And I'd like to thank everybody out there in the gang tuning in who's been telling their friends how WebOvision works. It's very complicated. A lot of times people, you say, go to the website, and they go, and it doesn't play, or they don't know how it works, because people aren't really used to watching TV yet on the internet in this sort of live format. So we're actually basically asking people out there to bring friends to the channel each night.
Yeah. Well, hopefully they do.
I heard you calling someone before the show and saying go go by the channel, to go by Tom.
Yeah, he did.
Who were you calling?
My friend, beautiful Jason Fiegel.
Yeah, I wonder if he'll even be able to get it working, because sometimes there's something you got to download. I don't know how it works. We're working on it. It's WebOvision. There's kinks in the system. We put all these cameras in last week, all these lights and stuff. This used to be my house.
You don't live here
anymore?
Well,
I do. No, I do live here, but it used to feel like my house. I mean, now it's just...
House/studio.
It's gotten a little weird.
That's kind of like an episode of Seinfeld.
And I can't leave now. Hello?
Tom?
Yeah.
I have a question for Wee Man or Preston.
Yeah, we have 20 minutes left, so I want to just keep taking calls, okay?
All right, just wondering why the Don Vito scene that was in the trailer wasn't in the movie.
We just cut so much film that we had an A+ movie already that it didn't fit in.
Yeah, we all lost footage. We knew it was gonna come down to that. It's gonna be tough at the end. We all lost footage. Yeah. We all lost stuff we loved.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hey man, what's up, Tom?
Hey. You have a question?
I was just wondering, like, what do you play a lot of video games and stuff like that?
Me personally, I played that game Medal of Honor for about 3 weeks straight at one point 2 years ago. I never have played a video game since.
You have a Miss Pac-Man.
And I have a Miss Pac-Man machine.
Actual arcade video game in your living room.
Which I play occasionally. What do you play video games? Do you guys play video games?
No.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're busy.
We're making TV and movies.
Hello.
Tom.
Yeah.
Hey, this is the guy that called earlier. You was asking if I was still on the line. You had a question you wanted to ask me?
Oh, no. Really? Well,
what makes you tick? What was your childhood like? Did you smoke cigarettes as a kid?
He's calling back.
I heard you as you hung up.
One of our three viewers. Hello.
How you doing, sir?
How are you?
I'm pretty good.
Good.
How you feeling? I wanted to say congratulations to Wee Man earlier when they said that he's expecting.
Oh, thank you.
Congratulations, Wee Man.
Yeah. Hopefully it's a little boy. I want my little buddy around.
But
you'll take it if it's a girl.
Is your son going to be a stuntman, skateboarder type daredevil, or are you going to discourage this kind of behavior?
No, I'm definitely going to encourage it. And me and my girlfriend were talking about it earlier. There's only 1 1/4 chance that he's going to be a little guy.
Yeah.
So he's probably going to be...
Is that actually how it
actual
works?
Like, you know, rocket science to the thing.
Interesting.
So I'll probably have a kid, and when he's 6, he's probably going to be bigger than dad.
Right.
And we were talking, because I have to have pedal extensions on
my car.
It's a
1 in 4 chance, though.
Yeah, 1 in 4 chance.
That he won't be bigger than dad. Now, how's that work? What is that called?
Dwarfism.
Okay, yeah, okay, cool.
Yeah, that's
really
what I am, yeah.
So 1 in 4.
1 in 4.
It's all about the position, though, right?
Yeah.
What's that?
it's connected to the position you have when you conceive.
Is it actually?
Yeah.
No.
Is that an urban legend?
Yeah.
A wives' tale.
It's jeans. Yeah. Not the jeans you're wearing. It's the jeans.
Sure. Cool.
But anyways, we were talking, and I have to have pedal extensions for my car, you know?
Uh-huh.
And we were thinking if the kid ever gets mad at us, he's going to be like, screw it, I'm just going to take dad's car. I can reach the pedals.
Yeah.
And there's a 6-year-old kid just getting in the car, driving off.
Right, sure, right. That's cool. Every kid gets in their car and takes off at one point.
And they do.
But then crashes into something because they can't reach the pedals.
But my kid's going to be driving.
He's going to be stoked. Hey, how are you?
Pretty good. How are you doing, sir? This is Tony Clifton.
What?
Tony Clifton?
This is Tony Clifton. I'm calling from Las Vegas.
Okay, cool. It's a good impression of Tony Clifton.
Sort of.
That's cool. I'll let you. Why don't you say something?
I just wanted to say, Wee Man's been out trying to impersonate me in Nevada. He put on a Tony Clifton suit.
All right, that's enough of that, though.
I thought he was actually going to get somewhere there for a minute.
Yeah. Hello, you're on the air.
Damn.
Tom, you are the fucking man.
How you doing?
Yeah.
Good. Calling out of. Preston.
Yeah.
Where did he get his name from?
Who?
Preston?
Wee Man.
Wee Man.
Question, where did Wee get his name from?
Oh.
It's obvious, is it?
Yeah, kind of obvious.
Hello?
It's either that or Corky.
You're on the air.
I wanted to say congratulations to Wee Man and ask how far along his baby is.
2.5 to 3 months right now. We don't know. We're going in for the ultrasound on October 5th, and we'll find out that it's my little dude.
Now let's explore that for a second, because that's really interesting to me and something I never would have expected to talk about tonight. There's a 1 in 4 chance, okay? So how do you find out when, you know,
My mom didn't know I was a little person. Well,
are you documenting on video the whole process of the and,
we haven't started, yeah, I started
the
taking,
pregnancy, the
I've
birth.
Started taking pictures, but I think I am going to start filming her belly, because it's just starting to come out.
Yeah.
And so I am going to start talking about it and talking about, like, the names. Again, I'm not going to say any of the names because I know all these web people are going to be like, oh, my God, we can't believe they came up with that name and steal it.
Uh-huh,
so I'm not going to give the names away. But my mom and my dad didn't know I was going to be a little person until I was 2 months old. But my mom had a feeling when I was in her belly. She used to see a little girl walk by her house, a short statured person,
uh-huh,
and say, I bet my baby's going to be a little person.
Wow.
And when I was 2 months old, then they realized that I was a little person.
Uh-huh. Had it been in her family before? Or?
No.
Oh, just
they can't. They couldn't trace it back any as far as they could. And I was talking to my dad, and he says, even if it is a chance, it's probably going to skip this generation and go into the next generation,
yeah,
if anything. So it's even probably slightly less of a chance than 1 in 4.
Yeah. Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Do you hope for either way?
Either way, I'm going to be the happiest dad in the world.
Almost,
little person.
You almost
not.
Would want him to be a little person, wouldn't you? You
know, cha-ching.
Cha-ching.
What an act.
Yeah.
Oh,
man.
Cool. Hello. Hello.
You're on the kid air. That house.
Hi, Tom.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm wonderful. How are you?
Good. I'm doing really good.
That's fabulous. Yeah. I was calling to actually ask you a question.
Okay.
About the channel. You keep talking about growing in viewership and everything. And
yeah, we're hoping to ask people to call people and explain to them how to log on every night. Like, you could call a couple of people when you get off and tell them to log on. That would increase our traffic.
I told 2 people.
Yeah.
He told another person.
It's like the Fabergé organic shampoo commercials of the late 70s. And so on, and so on.
Possibly.
Remember? I don't know what I'm talking about.
It
might be a Canadian thing.
Where was it?
Do you have a question?
Are you planning on doing more with the channel after it grows in viewership? Or is this going to always just be for...
We're making t-shirts!
We're thinking if it grows in viewership, we may do more with it, actually.
I can't wait for the home game.
Hello, you're on the air.
Hey, what's up?
Come on, we have 15 minutes left with these guys. They've got the number one movie in America. For crying out loud, let's not talk about the channel. We can talk about the channel and the blog. Ask your question.
I've actually got a question for Wee Man.
Yes.
Do you still skateboard?
Yeah, actually I do, and I just came out with a new board, too.
A new board? Who's it by?
It's by Two Felons. If you go to twofelons.com, you can buy it.
Two Felons?
Yep. It's a sick graphic. It's tattoo graphic.
I just want to say, Tom, I hope this ankle injury doesn't stop your skateboarding career.
Yeah. No, I'm considering it stopping.
No way.
I mean, thank you. It's weird, you know? I mean, are we getting old? What is it? I mean, you want to see, look, do you have a video queued up of when I broke my leg?
After this, I'm going to give you some advice.
Just look, leave our audio up and just play the clip. Play the clip under us so we don't have to stop talking. But this, look, this is how I broke my leg. Doing this. This is how I broke my leg. Watch. Over an orange hat. Jumping over a hat. Jumping over a hat.
When's the actual breaking?
Coming up. Not this one. Jumping, not that one. Jumping over a hat. I am 8 weeks. Not this one. This one. Watch. I step on the hat. It breaks. Boom!
Oh!
That's it. That's my broken leg. Okay, come out of that. That's it.
All right.
That's it. I stepped on an orange hat. I stepped on an orange hat.
You actually weren't even really skateboarding when you broke it.
I jumped over a hat, and then I jumped off the board, foot hit the orange hat, broke my leg.
You know, let's see. That is so gnarly.
Jumping over a hat. Yippee! I'm jumping over a hat.
That's gnarly. I have good advice for you, though.
Yeah. Quit skateboarding.
No, keep skateboarding. Never quit.
You know Jeremy Klein?
Yes.
Playboy Jeremy Klein. He is here every week. He's going to be starting a video game show. He's one of my best friends. He's got a broken ankle right now, too. Do you have Jeremy's footage of him breaking his ankle in there?
Jeremy's website page.
Oh, yeah.
Is so funny.
Oh, JeremyKlein.com.
He goes into like the restaurants. Yeah. And he's trying to eat, and there's a lady breastfeeding, and then all the kids crying.
JeremyKlein.com. He shoots it all from his cell phone.
He is so funny. That guy is funny.
He'll be here Friday night. Come by Friday night. Have some drinks with us. Dave Navarro's coming, I think, Thursday night.
Real quick advice, though. Dave Navarro?
We have Dave Navarro here Thursday. And Weird Al Yankovic here on Wednesday, here at the channel. Hello, you're on the air.
Yeah, hi. I was wondering how much it cost. Or no, not how much it cost. Did it cost a lot to make Jackass too?
No, we all just used our own home video cameras and spare tapes that we had. So
we all chipped in for like airfare, Southwest Super Savers and stuff.
And used our Golden Miles too.
Yeah, and our frequent flyer
miles. So we kept the budget of this film.
Like
down.
Our moms cooked and stuff.
What was
like
the budget?
Crock pots and stuff.
It is obviously
11.5 million.
It is that much. Yeah. Do you do a lot of travel for it?
Yeah.
We had a big international trip.
Where did you go in this new movie?
All over the United States and India.
Oh, really?
Yeah, 15 days in India.
Had you been there before?
I'd have already been there. I went there before, when Big Brother was around, I went there with my mom just to go on a little tour.
Uh-huh.
It was cool then. Second time was all right. But we kind of redid some stuff, so it wasn't like we wanted to show it in the movie.
Right.
The actual big footage was Preston chasing me, and then we went around a corner, and I had 20 little Indian dudes follow me, and we chased Preston.
20 little Indian dudes, huh?
Yeah.
Were they little Indian dudes, you mean?
Yeah.
Little.
Oh, like you mean little?
Wee dudes.
Oh, wee man was a god to them. They just wanted to touch him. That's all they wanted to do. They wanted to touch
where
him.
Where did you find the 20 little Indian dudes?
They got a billion people over there.
Yeah. Bollywood, right? That's probably.
Yeah. We filmed right at a soundstage in Bollywood. It was great. It was cool.
Cool. Hello, you're on the air.
How's it going?
We're doing good. We've got 10 minutes left, so ask away.
Awesome, hey, I'm calling from Ottawa.
Ottawa, Canada, my hometown. Yeah, cool.
Yeah, I just wanted to...
this should be good.
Oh, when Jackass 3 was coming out. No, I'm just kidding.
You
know how it was different shooting Jackass 2, now that, like, Johnny Knoxville's a superstar, Bam's a millionaire, how it was different than shooting Jackass 1?
We've got a journalist here.
Johnny Knoxville is absolutely no different than he was the very first day of shooting this TV series back in 99. And Bam, Millionaire Bam, has actually matured a lot now that he's 25. He's actually really come into his own. He's a great guy.
I've met Johnny Knoxville once. I believe he made fun of my shirt.
What shirt were you wearing?
It was like a cowboy shirt.
Did we saw you at like the VMA Video Music Awards or MTV Movie Awards?
Maybe it was there, yeah. It was there.
You had that Humplink dude with you.
I rarely leave the house.
Where is Humplink?
You know what? I'm not legally allowed to say.
Did he set up all this computer stuff for you?
No, I can't even.
You guys aren't speaking?
I can't even discuss it, really. It's a bad scene.
All right. Yeah. We're over it.
Hello.
Wow, it's like Paris and Nicole.
You're, no, he's doing good. He's doing good. He's doing good. I'm just hype kid. He's doing good. Hello.
Hello. This is Hans. I'm going from Norway.
Oh, Norway. Okay, awesome.
I got a question for Tom and Preston.
Yes, go ahead. Question.
What's the most gross thing they've ever done?
The grossest thing that you've ever
grossest done? Grossest thing. The most ultimate grossest thing they've ever done.
Grossest. Do you like when they call it gross out comedy? I don't like that, really.
Yeah, as long as they fill the theaters, we don't give a shit. I don't know, the grossest thing is probably pooping in a funnel that was connected to Steve-O's mouth. It's hard to beat that.
Hello?
Hello.
You're on movie phone.
Hello, and welcome to movie
you're
phone.
You're on the air.
All right, oops. I was going to ask Preston, heard Knoxville stabbed Steve-O with a sword. What's up with that?
Yeah, yes, he did.
What happened?
No, we were doing a photo shoot for GQ magazine. You know, one of our many photo shoots. And, Knoxville was dressed as a four-star general with a sword, and Steve-O went snuck behind the backdrop to do some whippet hits and smoke some pot, and Knoxville didn't know he was back there, and he slammed that sword through the backdrop, and it went an inch into Steve-O's back. And Steve-O was all right and didn't want to go to the hospital, but there was so much blood they had to take him in and get him checked out.
So, I mean, you guys got to be careful, sort of, though, right? Like, what, something's going to happen.
Well, that was an accident. That wasn't like a stun. There was
stabbed with a sword.
But that didn't, you know, but, like, that didn't involve MTV or Paramount Pictures at all. That was us and some
you guys
photographers
a sword,
from GQ.
Messing around with a sword, huh? Yeah, that's cool. Stabbed with a sword. Hello?
Hello.
Hello.
I had a question for Wee Man and Preston. I was wondering, do you guys ever get mad? Does anybody in the group ever get mad at each other? Because wondering who the biggest baby is.
Who's the biggest baby?
Well, Aaron always gets mad, but I recall one time Preston was dressed in a cow suit, and he was feeding baby calf through the udders.
Okay, yeah.
And I had a cow prong, and I was about to go, you know, taser him, and he got real pissed. And I went, oh, shit, he has mad cow disease.
We almost had a fist fight as I was dressed as a huge cow.
Yeah. Has there ever been situations where somebody, you're all, the bit's all set up, like you said, ready to shoot, props are all there, the stunt or what have you is ready to go, and then person just chickens out, can't do it.
Usually they'll try a stunt and it won't succeed.
Yeah.
You know?
But has there ever been an occasion where something's been totally set up, ready to go, and then somebody's just, you know, I'm not even going to try.
Well, I can't really list a bit, but the Indian government shut us down on a bit like 5 seconds before I was due to get done.
Because for you can't say the name of it?
No, because we want to do it in the future.
So it's some sort of a elaborate stunt, death-defying, and
surgery,
the Indian government.
Like a surgery cannibalism type wacky thing.
Cannibalism. Is that where we're going?
We're going to cannibalism.
We're taking it up a level there, Tom.
Is this really where it's, is this the notch? The notch up? Cannibalism?
The notch up.
How do we, are really?
Serious.
Is this news here that we're breaking here on Talking
Live
right
now? No, we touched on the press junket.
You're touching on cannibalism?
Yeah.
How?
Is that strange? Canada, they don't do that?
Seriously, how? For real? That was it for real?
No, for real.
It's real, but I don't want to lose the bit. I don't want to tease your audience at all because they've been really cool. But yeah, I don't want to give away the bit.
Like eating a corpse kind of thing?
No.
Not that cannibalism.
Are you guys going to eat a corpse?
No.
You're not getting it out of us. Sorry,
I don't
want to dance around your audience.
That would be
we ain't even dancing.
To eat a human corpse, like on with the Chilean soccer team, you know, when the plane goes down in the Alps in the Andes or whatever, and they eat. You could probably get a corpse somewhere at like a medical waste facility.
Is this where we say next?
Or just eat
next caller.
Next caller. We're not going there.
I don't know. That sounds like crazy. I might eat a human arm for a few extra rating points around here.
The best meat's in the run.
You know, my wheels are turning. Hello?
Hello?
Hello.
How you doing, sir?
Good. That's Andy Dick right there. It's a picture of Andy Dick.
I was
you guys know
wondering.
Him?
Is that him on the phone?
No, is this it? No, it's not. I wish it was.
Dick, hey.
Hey, how are you?
Pretty good. I'm Andy Dick.
Who is this, for real?
This is Tyler Hazlett. You added me a couple days ago, Deputy Wise.
Okay, well, listen to me. Just fell into place. Come on. Hello? Okay, we got 6 minutes. Let's just plow through. Does it, you guys want a beer or anything?
No, I'm good.
No? Want to meet my parrot? You guys want to meet my parrot?
What's his name again?
Rex Murphy. Oh, actually, I didn't even realize I could roll around on this chair. This is actually awesome.
Are you good?
I'm okay. Yeah, here, Rex, come here. Come meet these guys. Come here. Come here.
This is going to go horribly wrong.
Yeah, it's definitely.
I don't like where this is going,
Rex,
Tom.
Rex is the friendliest parrot ever. Come on.
I'll hold him.
Come on. Come on. Come here.
He's
come
pissed.
Here. Come here. Come here. No, it's just because I'm not holding him the way he normally would be because I'm busted up here.
Because you're
here
injured?
Yeah, because I'm injured.
You want me to get him?
There we go. I got him.
You know what this reminds me of? Fifth grade.
Hi. No, she's cool. She's like a sweetheart.
Hi. That's a pretty bird.
Say hi to Wee Man. Wee Man.
Pretty bird. Is that bird an illegal immigrant?
She's cool. She may bite, but she's not too bad. She's pretty friendly for a macaw.
Macaw?
Okay, so this has been a fun night. I mean, we have 5 minutes left, but I'm just. Oh, are you having some? Are you a Jaeger drinker?
Yeah, I found your fridge. Thanks.
Oh, I'll have a shot of that. I'll have a shot of that right now. Yeah, yeah. Get that in there. No, but I mean, this has been fun having you guys here. I appreciate it.
It's been.
We really are going to start having little get-togethers here on
Friday nights
and have bands and stuff. So you guys just come on back.
No, you messed up. You told us you were having a party and you invited Steve-O.
So yeah, this Friday, yeah.
It's going to get ugly.
It's
going to get ugly.
The house going to burn down again or something like that?
I actually, my manager just got a call for me and Preston to go do an appearance. Mm-hmm. And he goes, well, do you want Steve-O too? And he goes, nah, he's kind of too much of a liability.
Really?
Yeah.
What are the most outrageous things that happen when you're with Steve-O that would earn him such a reputation?
You never know.
Really?
Yeah.
Is he like the guy you're always kind of, when you go out with him, you're always kind of worried about him?
You're not worried because you know it's just him.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You've been looking after him sometimes? Or is he
no.
Just...
No, you don't really look after him.
Not
you
at
try
all.
To get away from him sometimes.
Yeah. You're trying to pawn him on to other people that never hung out with him.
Uh-huh.
They think, oh man, he's so wild and we love him right now.
Uh-huh.
Wait till 6 a.m., bub.
I would like to see that.
Yeah.
You guys all hang out in L.A.?
Yeah.
Yeah? Together? Yeah. You guys just go, what, you go to clubs or something? Or you go hang out? Or what do you do?
More of like a dive bar or something. We'll all get together and hit a dive bar. Yeah. Just because we have fun no matter where. We don't need to go to a big club.
Cool. Hello?
Hi, what's your guys' favorite Seinfeld episode, all of you? I heard you guys talking about it earlier.
Favorite Seinfeld episode?
We were talking about it?
Yeah, I was talking about it earlier. Oh, there's tons
of you were, really?
Yeah, I was.
On this show tonight?
Yeah, because Kramer did that thing where he set up the Merv Griffin set in his house.
Oh, yeah,
and that's
yeah.
why I said this feels like kind of like the
that's cool. Seinfeld.
It's one of my favorite shows. It's a great show.
Yeah, yeah.
I like the jack-off competition is probably the best episode.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then when they had that.
You guys did the real version of that, didn't you?
Yeah. I won it for speed. And then when the plane was crashing in Seinfeld, they're like, they're on their deathbed, and George is like, I cheated, I lied.
Okay, last call of the night. Let's make it a good one.
Yeah.
Okay, and it's been a blast here, Tom Green Live, every night, 11 Eastern. Last call of the night, make us proud.
Hello, cocksucker.
Hello. Hey, Tom, this is Nesbitt from NAC.
Hello.
Hello. Tom, this is Nesbitt from NAC.
Hey, how are you? Say something.
Pretty good. I broke my foot yesterday. I was going to say keep skating because I am. But
Yeah, no, I'll keep skating. I'm just got to take it easy.
Yeah.
Watch your
eyes. I got a question for Wee Man.
Yeah.
Just watch
have
your
you,
eyes.
Had any injuries lately?
No, my last one was October 3rd last year when I broke my femur.
And then there was the macaw gouging his eye the second you asked that question.
And the following lawsuit.
Awesome, guys. Hey, thanks, man.
Thank you for having us,
Tom.
It's been fun.
Thanks, Tom.
Congratulations on the new expected.
Say hi, babe, so everybody knows.
Come say hello.
Yeah,
come wave.
Say hello real quick.
Give a little
real
wave.
Quick, man.
Look what we brings to the party.
Come on over here.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
This is my lady.
No, do not. Okay. Thanks for coming, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good night, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow night here at 11 o'clock Eastern.
8 p.m. Pacific.
At the channel. Okay. Good night. Thanks, guys. Bring your ass. Come here, buddy. Come here.
Before, thank you, sir.
Before someone loses an eye.
And here we are, and Dr. Yacoubian is about to come and see us here. I'm going to take off my pants in a minute.
Be a lot of fun.
Yeah, I'm making a little video.
Oh, yeah. My God, no, I'm scared.
Yeah, so what's going on here? I'm about to have surgery.
Oh. Thank you. And a little bee sting here. Bit of a poke.
Oh, that's a...
I know.
That's a good one.
What about your hands?
That's the IV. Oh boy. Gotta stop doing that heroin.
I'm hurting.
It's okay. It's not in, it's not going in, right?
No.
Doctor.
Blood should be gushing out.
Blood should be gushing out. This is a bad IV day? You're having a bad IV day.
I'm having a bad
IV day.
You're having a bad IV day. God.